Hi, I'm Tequila Carter. I have served as the anesthesia simulation director for about 5 years, along with Aaron Blanchard, the associate program director, Tyler Burks, the simulation operations technician, and Dr. Grace Rayfield, who served as the assistant program director. Recently, Dr. Rayfield and I switched places, and she is now the director. As a team, we have expanded the anesthesia simulation program considerably during these 5 years. Our residents participate in different types of simulation from the time they start their intern year through their third clinical anesthesia year, or CA3 year. In conjunction with UAB Clinical Simulation or Office of Interprofessional Simulation for Innovative Clinical Practice, we provide high quality, high fidelity immersive sims, procedural sims, hybrid sims, and OSCE prep or objective structured clinical examination preparation simulations. All of our residents participate in at least 2 high fidelity immersive simulations a year. This is where we put the residents in a simulated environment that we have made as close to the real clinical environment as possible, allowing them to practice clinical management as well as crisis resource management techniques. Their patients are usually sophisticated mannequins, which can mimic human body functions. We combine the mannequins with simulated patients who portray surgeons, family members, and nurses in the perioperative environments. Our residents perform multiple procedural simulations, such as insertion of central venous, peripheral intravenous, and arterial lines, along with placement of epidurals and spinals. I teach you ultrasound modules are another type of procedural simulation we provide for all of our residents. These modules include transthoracic and transesophageal echocardiogram, ultrasound-guided vascular access, and pulmonary and gastric ultrasound. We use a flipped classroom approach where residents review electronic content independently before having a hands-on workshop. They then complete simulation case studies on a state-of-the-art trainer to further improve their skills. First clinical anesthesia year, or CA1 year, residents transition from intern year to anesthesia. We have an anesthesia simulation bootcamp in conjunction with the department's anesthesia didactic bootcamp. During our simulation bootcamp, we use both immersive and procedural simulation throughout the sessions to prepare the residents to care for patients in perioperative settings. During their CA1 through CA3 years, each resident takes part in an annual OSCE preparation simulation. We perform this OSCE prep in the same style of the American Board of Anesthesiology. This allows the residents an opportunity to practice for their required OSCE for board certification. We do many additional simulations, such as a difficult airway workshop, or the FCCS, or Fundamentals of Critical Care Support simulations, and simulations for our fellows. Overall, our program simulations continue to receive excellent evaluations, with residents saying that it gives them hands-on practice and a chance to think through critical events before they happen in clinical practice. COVID has definitely changed the number of residents that can participate in simulations at one time, but we have adjusted and are back on track to give our residents what they need to be successful. Thank you, and I look forward to seeing you.